not much obliged to you, Major Buxton and Captain Danforth. Well, I'll learn them fellas to shoot the best I can, like I already done Pusher and Bert. I mean, Privates Ross and Thomas. But I don't want to be no corporal.
What's that?
I said I don't want to be no corporal.
Why not?
Wait a minute, Captain. Let him talk.
Well, you see,
Is it because of your religious convictions, York?
Yes, sir. That's it. You see, I believe in the Bible, and I'm believing that this here life we're living is something the Lord done give us, and we got to be living it the best we can. And I'm figuring that the killing other folks ain't no part of what he was intending for us to be a-doing here.
Well, yes, in a way, I agree with you.
York, with your permission, Major.
Certainly, Captain. Sit down, York.
You say you believe in the Bible.
Yes, sir.
Well, I do, too. But do you believe that the Bible means that a man shouldn't fight for what he believes to be right?
Well, it done said, blessed are the peacemakers.
Yes, I know, but you remember that verse, I think it's in Luke, where he says, he that hath no sword, let him sell his garment and buy one?
He said that to Peter. But he doesn't stop Peter from using the sword. He said, them that lives by the sword will be a-perishing by the sword. That, further on.
Yes, I remember, but...
Now, go ahead, Captain.
But according to St. John, he said, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servant fight.
Well, that's just the point, Captain. He done said his kingdom were not of this world. And that a different.
Yes, but
just a moment, Captain. York, have you ever read this?
History of the United States.
Yeah, sure a lot of writing.
Daniel Boone.
Yeah. You know about him?
Everybody down there way knows about Daniel Boone, the first man into the Valley of the Three Forks.
Yeah, he was quite a man. One of the greatest. And that book's full of great men. York, what do you suppose that Boone was looking for when he went out alone into the wilderness?
Well, I never thought much on it.
Was he looking for new lands?
Might be.
Maybe. Maybe for something more. Something that a man just can't see with his eyes or hold in his hands. Something that some men don't even know they have until they've lost it.
Yes, sir.
To be free. Now, that's quite a word, freedom. I think that's what he wanted. I think that's what sent Boone into your Tennessee country.
Is that what this here book's about?
Yep. That's the story of a whole people's struggle for freedom. From the very beginning until now. For we're still struggling. It's quite a story, York. How they all got together and set up a government. Whereby all men were pledged to defend the rights of each man. And each man to defend the rights of all men. We call it a government of the people. By the people. And for the people.
I never knowed it was all written down.
You're a religious man, York.
Yes, sir.
You want to worship God in your own way.
Yes, sir.
You're a farmer.
Yes, sir.
You want to plow your fields as you see fit and raise your family according to your own lights. And that's your heritage. And mine, every American's. But the cost of that heritage is high. Sometimes it takes all we have to preserve it, even our lives. How are you going to answer that, York?
Well, you done give me a powerful lot to be a-thinking about.
Well, take your time.
Well, if I could only get home, back in them there hills,
what would you do?
Well, I could figure something out. I done a heap of thinking up beyond the there once.
All right, take 10 days furlough.
You mean I can go home?
And when you get back, if you still can't see it our way, I'll recommend your exemption.
You will?
Report to me as soon as you get back.
I'll arrange you for New York starting tomorrow.
Thank you. Good luck.